So the next topic is like similar to the fun part, but with the professors and fellow scholars. How was the interaction time? And what about the availability of the professor or your fellow members when you were doing research or a course room? How was it?
In my group, of course, it varies from group to group. There are several different groups in any university. The professors, I'll just divide it into two parts, of course, the professors and then your fellow colleagues. With the professors, it's a little tricky to always get them to meet you. So, because they're very busy. So honestly, it's like teaching is sort of like a part-time thing for them. They are more into the research and they're always traveling here and there for conferences. So it's a little difficult to get hold of your professor. What I would suggest is get into a discussion with the professor and everything even before you enroll in the university, which is what I did. So I was already, because I knew which group I wanted to go into. So if you do a little bit of your own research, they know that somebody's going to come in this year, in this cohort, who already wants to work here. So it's a very good impression. So they will also try to make it a point to like meet you as much as possible, because they also want to sort of recruit you in their group. So that I think makes a difference. It's sort of like a first impression is the last impression kind of a thing. With the your colleagues, it was excellent. Like you can always, I'm very grateful to my supervisor actually, my mentor. So everyone who does their work in a research group, you're assigned a mentor who is usually a PhD student or a postdoctoral person, candidate. And I'm very thankful, I'm very grateful. He is amazing at what he does, and he was always there helping me, very patient. All my colleagues were also very good. There is usually no problem in that, because the research also helps the group a lot, and they know that you're new, so they will, in every group, they will always help you. But there's always like a little bit of independent driven structure, so they also prefer that you also have your own ideas and you come up with your, it is much better if you come up with your own idea of a thesis project instead of them suggesting a thesis project to you. So that really helps. But with the professors it's a little harder than with any kind of colleague, be it a postdoctoral candidate, be it being a technician in the lab, be it an engineer or a PhD or just your fellow student. It was very, very good, so no complaints there.
That is good to hear actually. That is one of the best thing which is required for all the scholars. You have to interact with the professor and fellow colleagues. That is very important. That is very good to hear. And I think you have enjoyed that atmosphere, right? You have completed almost, right?
Yeah, I have finished. I have finished. I have already graduated. I did a year of research work and then I left. So yeah.
So coming to the completion part, like what about this job perspectives? Like are there any sort of, like in India, you have seen that job placements and placements and all. So what was the placement scenario? Like is there any third party companies will come and hire, or how it goes, the selection process?
Yeah, so there is no placement per se, but there is a career fair that we have, which is organized by the university every February, annually every February. And it's for 3 days. It's called the Sebitraitantach. And people go, so there are a lot of companies which come for that, but they don't essentially come to recruit anyone. They will have their own stalls there, and then you're supposed to go there, talk to them, tell them your profile, whatever, carry a resume with you. And if they like you, they'll be like, okay, then, you know, this is the link, you can go and apply there. So there is no placement per se that happens in Tudor. You essentially, what we always do is, the career fairs are good, but they are not, if you are just relying on a career fair for your jobs, that is not recommended. So what people usually do is maybe a month before graduating, if you want to like not have a gap and just begin immediately, then a month or 2 months before graduating, you start looking for your jobs, for jobs and anything. It's a little hard because they, TUDelft is very, okay, one thing as well that goes in with this, the completion factor. In TUDelft, there is no convocation. So everybody doesn't graduate together. Everybody graduates individually. So when you submit your diploma, I guess it's the same like in MS by research in the IITs, I'm not exactly sure, but it seems something like that, right? So it's like that. So until unless they are satisfied with your work, you cannot graduate. So it's that's why it becomes a little hard. And there's no convocation ceremony, nothing. On the day you defend your thesis, after those 2 hours of grilling and like super a lot of work, after that you get your degree in your hand. That's it. So because of that, because it's so strenuous, the thesis experience where you really have to work, but the work that you do is very fulfilling. So after you finish that, a lot of people choose to look for jobs after they graduate because you get a 1 year search visa in the Netherlands. Okay. So you can live there for 1 year. And if you find a job within that 1 year, you can also work with that visa. So it's a search visa and a work visa. So it's like a normal online, you have to look for jobs like online and stuff, and don't just rely on camp and on that career fair. There are also other career fairs that are held by, let's say, the Korean embassy. The Korean embassy will have a huge Korean company's career fair, not in Delft, but like in a neighboring city like Rotterdam or The Hague. And everyone is free to go there. But always suggested to start looking for jobs, start applying for jobs online and follow the grind rather than just relying on the campus fair.
Yeah, I think that is good to know the people who are going there. Like some people go for job prospectus and to work there. For those people, it's very good to know. But now the topic what we are going to speak, it may be shared in different video. Please, if you complete this watching this video, please join in the other video. We'll be talking on a different topic now. This is continuation with this job prospectus, but very interesting. Please check out that one. Okay, coming to the next continuation topic for the context. So I'm asking now you have said we need to connect with us, surfing to the websites and finding the relevant jobs or whatever, the company details and all. So I'm taking this analogy, like the way you approach for your master's or PhD abroad and the way you wanted to, you have to apply for jobs. I feel there is a similarity. What do you say?
Exactly. I couldn't agree more, because this is something that I've been telling so many people over the last 1 or 2 years, that it's the same thing. Like, you just have to do the exact same thing. The uncertainty is the same. Everything is the same. But
I'm like encouraging this point of view and the application time itself, because like the efforts I'm saying, many people like, please understand the process. Don't just ask somebody what to do, how to apply, and don't ask somebody. Please try to spend some time to understand the application process when you try for abroad studies. Again, the same process, you can use it for job search. So
exactly.
You may need to have cover letter, you may need to have a CV, or again, you need to find the company details. It is similar to like find a faculty of your research interest and find a research lab. Try to convince their relevance with you with a technical explanation. And again, cover letter, which is similar to research proposal I'm comparing.
Yes.
So it is like almost like you are preparing to work in a different country, not just for studying, you are preparing for working also in a way.
Exactly. Yeah, I mean, it's exactly the what you've said is just so much on point. Yeah.
Yeah. And again, I'd like to add a comment again saying like, one thing, let's say some person is trying for somewhere studying abroad, like any other country. So they have studied. And again, they went for some selection and they couldn't get till the final. But the process, they can even, from their home country, they can still apply for jobs.
Yes.
Even for higher studies, you can still apply for jobs even with the same experience, the same efforts you can put. Now you learned the process, you apply for jobs also.
Yes.
So likewise, yeah. I think your off-campus happened the same way, right?
Yeah. I also, like I just said, we don't have anything like campus placement, so everything is basically off campus. So you look for jobs wherever you want or wherever you would like to go.
True. So find the company and prepare the documents and find almost is similar. And I think this is this is just a comparison. I have already spoken about in detail. That will be preceded in this video. By this time, it is the video. So. That is fine. So coming to the another question about this TU Delft. So any other learnings or lessons you wanted to share with the aspiring people, where you find, okay, I could have done this thing, but this is not happened by then?
One thing that I would like to share is a lot of people, it's very normal for, like, because we come from a very competitive culture. Society is very competitive in India and everything. What we as graduates always do is, as soon as we finish our undergrad, we're always trying to look for the best universities in terms of ranking to go into. And people don't usually focus. I mean, this is what I have noticed. This might necessarily not be everyone's case, but a lot of my friends, even me myself personally, initially, I was very much like, okay, if I want to go abroad, I really have to make sure that I get the highest score in my GRE. Of course, I mean, you have to do well in your bachelor's. Like, that is a prerequisite. But, like, I have to get the highest score, and then if I it doesn't matter which course I go to. A lot of people do that. It doesn't matter. I just want to go to this university. And then they apply only for the highest, like, things, that any course in any in the best university. And sometimes you get it, and you go, you do it, but you don't like it. So one thing which is very important to understand is that your master's is basically a stepping stone into your working life. And just like your bachelor's is a stepping stone into your working life. So it's very important for you to like what you do. So you should make sure that you look into the research and the work that your university people are doing. Not so, I mean, ranking is important, but it's not really the most important thing. The research is, in my opinion, the most important thing. So they might not be, like, there might be some university which is not, like, at the highest rung in, I don't know, like, let's say Harvard or something. Engineering is not very famous there. But Harvard School of Law is so good. But if you go there for engineering, it's not that good. Like, in TU-Delft as well, like, computer science is not very, very renowned. But it is, TU-Delft is world number 2 in architecture, world number 3 in civil, world number 11 in electrical. So this is fine, but if you go there for computer science, it's not really in the picture. But people are, you should just look at the research. If the research is good, then you should go for that. And that is one thing that I was, like, a little bit not sure about initially. I was looking at all of these rankings and stuff, but then I looked at the research and it really helps. Because then you will be working on a thesis, and your thesis, whatever you do for your thesis, is something that the companies will ask if you don't have any experience. And if you're a fresh grad, they're going to look at your thesis work. So make sure you look at the university and the work that they are doing, and if it lines with you. And another thing is, you might go into the university thinking that I want to work in a specific line. That can sometimes change, especially if you're fresh grad without any experience. You might go in thinking, like I went in thinking I wanted to work in biomems. That was my idea. I was always fascinated with biomems. I had worked on my bachelor's. I went in, and then I sort of changed and I diverted, and I started really enjoying this organ on a chip technology, and eventually I graduated in semiconductor fabrication with organ on chip technology, which is completely different from what I wanted to go in when I initially went in. So don't have a very open mind when you go into this thing.
I think that is a very crucial point what you have just mentioned. So I always emphasize this concept, actually. Please be open to learning things, actually, and learning to enjoy the process, so that you will accept the things very well, and you will end up in somewhere where you not even expected what we call the results. That will be very well, what we call, is essential, I can say. So I think this topic of this discussion, what I have thought, it is completed. So if you wanted to share your Facebook or Instagram, which one is the best one? Like, either which media is best for you? Say that one, so I'll put on the screen.
Sure, you can always contact me on Twitter, actually, because Facebook and Instagram, I usually use it for, like, very personal reasons. But I have a Twitter which I use for things like this, so you can always contact me on Twitter. It's RAJS2403.
RAJS2403.